11月11号，乌克兰的国旗正式的在赫尔松升起。赫尔松呢，是这场战争大概前面一刚开始没有多久，俄罗斯就占领的城市，大概占领了将近8个月。一个月之前，他开始撤退当地亲俄罗斯的民众，然后撤了人之后，这个礼拜开始撤军，最后11月11号，乌克兰军队跟乌克兰当地支持乌克兰军队的人高兴的欢欣鼓舞的升起了乌克兰的国旗，这当然对他们是感激涕零的一幕。可是这也代表很可能因为其中选举拜登没有输掉，而 Zelensky 他的口气也越来越强，他说要和谈可以，条件第一个就是领土完整，意思是克里姆林宫呢必须连克里米亚半岛乌东全部都还给他，第二个要惩罚所有的战争犯罪者包括普丁，第三个保证这种情况不会再发生，第四个补偿所有乌克兰的损失。那他提出来的和谈条件其实就是等于不可能和谈，白宫已经表示其中选举之后对乌克兰支持不变，美国将为乌克兰提供5.6亿元的军援，包括复仇者防空导弹，但是不提供乌克兰先进的无人机，避免与俄罗斯的冲突升级。所以你们注意到，拜登政府在其中选举之前一度想跟俄罗斯有更多的接触，跟一些和解，接着其中选举他没有大败之后，他继续的支持乌克兰，现在更新的目标是不可以提供先进的无人机，避免跟俄罗斯的冲突升级。我们来看一下的报道。
The choreography went like this. Stony-faced Russian commander in Ukraine, General Sergei Serovikin,advises his boss that the best option is for their forces to withdraw from Kherson city across the Dnipro River.
I understand it's a very difficult decision, but at the same time, we will save the lives of our servicemen.
Serovikin, I agree with your conclusions and your offers. Let's start the troop withdrawal.
It was framed in terms of protecting civilians and preserving Russian forces. It was a retreat, or at least the presentation of retreat, by PowerPoint.
酝酿多周的赫尔松战役11月9号发生重大转折。电视转播俄罗斯军方的战况简报中，总司令苏洛维金说明，在乌军重炮轰炸下，涅伯河西岸的俄军难以获得补给，并守住防御阵线。防长绍伊古同意下令将士兵和武器撤退到涅伯河东岸，这个普丁10月5号才签署立法正式兼并的地区，却在一个月后下令弃守，且在战争消息严格把关的俄罗斯军方上演撤军桥段，不免引发高度解释。西方分析认为，撤军行动默认挫败，质疑俄军怎么会轻易离开具有高度战略重要性的赫尔松市。
So what does this mean? Because these images broadcast by state television.
But, you know, that was an extraordinary event. I don't think I've ever seen anything like that on Russian television. You know, and for Putin, it's humiliating, but it's interesting that Putin wasn't there. You know, it's Putin's war, and yet it's Shoigu who's having to take responsibility by being the man.
Well, it's huge because this is a very important city strategically. It's a port city, and it's symbolically so important to Russia because it is the only major regional hub that Russia has managed to take in Ukraine that it didn't have before the invasion. So since February, that's the main gain they've made. So to give it up is a really important turning point in the war.
分析认为，莫斯科为避免重演俄军从哈尔科夫落荒而逃般的撤离，当时还留下大量完好的军武装备，选择事先宣布撤军，定调军方是为保留兵力，避免不必要的牺牲。不过，俄军3月初就攻占下赫尔松市，引入俄国货币，改用俄国电信商，转播俄国电视。赫尔松市还已正式并入俄罗斯，怎么会走到撤军这一步？
Krish, before this invasion, Kherson City had a population on a par with someplace like Cardiff, just over 300,000. There are just 60,000 people left in that city now. Kherson City was taken by the Russians quickly at the beginning of the war. Cue anti-Russian demonstrations on the streets. But then fast forward to last month. The Ukrainian advance has slowly fomented to the north and east of the city. Then proxy Russian officials there started calling for residents to evacuate. Last week, the offices of the puppet administration were abandoned, as were military bases.
数周来，军事专家分析都指出，涅伯河西岸的俄军面临苦战，乌军缓慢但稳定收复西岸地区，并切断西岸俄军的补给线，步步逼近赫尔松市中心。俄军总司令苏洛维金九月也警告，西岸战况艰困，眼看俄军处境越来越恶化。军事专家认为，普丁意识到俄军苦撑死守的结果会更糟糕，且将士兵退到涅伯河东岸也符合战术推演。随着乌军收复更多西岸地区，俄军只会更加孤立无援。
Whenever they move back across the river, and looking at it in a little bit more detail, we see that the river itself is a significant obstacle. It's about a kilometre wide in some of its shallower areas, and the bridges have been dropped by the Ukrainians. The Russians are relying on ferries and barge bridges to get their troops out, but they're putting layered defences on the eastern side in two or three layers, and they want to hold that through the winter to stop the Ukrainians getting forward.
乌方表示，确实看到俄军撤离西岸的迹象，指出俄军运走军事装备，并炸路桥、埋地雷，阻碍乌军前进，保护俄军安全撤退。且在俄方宣布撤军后，乌军在西岸的进攻明显遭遇较少的俄军阻挡。乌方称成功收复更多地区，基辅依旧保持高度警戒，也担心俄军撤离下一步又会是另一波大规模轰炸。
Putin will not take this lying down, and I think she suspects that he will throw everything at destroying civilian targets in retaliation.
不过，密切观察普丁的卡内基国际和平基金会访问学者斯塔诺瓦亚认为，俄罗斯撤军显示普丁愿意做出战术让步，这正好证实普丁是很务实的人，他没有我们认为的那么疯狂。英国退役空军少校贝尔则认为，俄方失去赫尔松市固然是一大重击，但莫斯科的首要目标一直是顿巴斯地区，估计撤离的俄军将会重新部署到顿巴斯。
The big man himself preoccupied, it seems, with other things: a tour of a hospital, a meeting with veterans, leaving the military mess to his generals to take care of.
乌军顺利收复赫尔松市，下一步将可往北推进，增加夺回扎波罗热俄军占领区的机会，还可往南进攻，推进克里米亚。而且就在西方盟友对无止境援乌开始动摇之际，俄军在涅伯河西岸的挫败也有助增强西方的援乌动力。
Well, for the Ukrainians, Kherson is the gateway to a possible effort to retake Crimea. And for the Russians, Kherson is the possible gateway to an effort to take the southern Ukrainian coast, the key port cities of Mykolaiv and Odessa. So if Russia loses Kherson, as it appears that they now have, that really precludes any opportunity the Russians might have to try to advance along the southern Ukrainian coast. And it exposes Crimea as potentially vulnerable to a Ukrainian offensive.
俄罗斯国防部11月11号表示，所有士兵都已撤到涅伯河东岸。美国参谋总长密利认为，乌军趁取得战场优势之际坐上谈判桌，但拜登幕僚认为谈判时机尚未成熟，现在提议停火谈判会让拜登政府被看成抑制乌军气势，白宫也不想被认为施压基辅放弃领土。分析认为，华府出现分歧的声音更多是测试谈判水温，这场战争怎么结束，何时结束，也将决定会是拜登的政绩还是包袱。